Yes.
Good morning to all of you. Today, I, Anshu Moises, going to deliver a speech on the topic, the rat race of being the best. I am talking about the race of everyone's life. You have to run as fast as you can. And not only the children, but parents also motivate their children to participate in this race. And gradually, this motivation increases as a pressure upon the children, and ultimately it causes their commission of suicide. I am not the first one talking about this race. Many other people have also called this race a gutter, but no one tries to see its brighter face. Actually, I think a race is very much natural in our surrounding. Even the plants have to compete with each other for more sunlight and nutrients. So we can find out that a race is very much natural in our surroundings. We can find that a race is common in multiple fields like business, education, etc. And there are also many merits of such a competition, as we can find in the business field. One company competes with other companies and tries to improve the quality of their products in the contrast to the quality of the products of other companies, and overall result that we get from such a competition is that a more good variety of products occur in the market, and also consumers get products of improved quality. Also in the field of education, this race encourages the children, or what we can call forces a child to give his her best and to utilize his resources in a more organized way, and it forces a child to give his 100% and to get a maximum percentage in their exams. So we can say that a race is very much helpful, but this race is very helpful, but only for those who can make up their pace and get a good rank, but not for those who were lagged behind and could not achieve a rank. As our society discourages them and it thinks that best is everything but better is nothing, the parents of such a society becomes happy on seeing their children at the first position, but never thinks whether their child would be happy or even in the second position or not. Now, without getting result, let's come to the harshest phase of this race, where crumbled the own dreams and hobbies of the child. This race lets you forget your own hobbies and creates a thirst of success in your mind. So conclusively, we find out that a race is very helpful, a competition is very much helpful in increasing your qualities, but our society needs some promotion and some awareness. Our parents should understand the potential of their children and then fix goals for them. That's all. Thank you.
Very good. Why you have chosen this topic? Reason?
Because we can say that our 10th board has arrived and I was facing the same experience, so I chose this topic.
Okay. Is there anyone who want to ask question related to this topic? You have to raise your hand and you may ask question. Any question? Okay, now go. Now next, roll number 2. You all have to listen carefully whatever he and she is speaking. And if you want to ask question, you may arise, okay? Now, next roll number 2, Anshu has delivered his speech. Now Meenakshi, it's your turn.
Good morning to all of you. I am Meenakshi, standing in front of you to tell my ASL topic, We Live in Deaths, Not in Years. Life is a boon of God. It must be meaningful. Life is what we make of it. If we don't try to give it a concrete shape, it is formless. A question arises, what is life and how should we lead? Life doesn't come in seconds, minutes, hours, weeks, months or years. It comes from every single moment. So we must squeeze the juice of life from every single moment. We must try to lead a meaningful life. We must use every moment to achieve higher goal in life. We should use every moment to create a new world for coming generation. Life is not measured by the years we live. It is measured by the works we do in life. If a man lives for 100 years, but He spent his time in idleness, so their life is not worth living. The worth to living life is measured by its not measured by its length. A short worth life is much better than the long life of idleness. Everyone wants to live long, but long life is useless if it passes more in eating, walking, chatting and sleeping. On the other hand, a short life is good if it is spent in doing good work. Swami Vivekananda lived for a very short time, but in a short time, short period of time is far superior to the long life of other who is spent in idleness. There are some days our short time is fleeting. We should always try to do something valuable work. If we want to be remembered after leaving this world, we must keep it in our mind. Miles to go before I sleep. Miles to go before I sleep. Thank you.
Okay. Why you have chosen this topic?
Because I like this topic.
You like this topic, so you have chosen. Okay, now, is there anyone related to this topic? You have to ask question. If you want to ask, then you may ask. Whatever she delivered related to this. Okay, now.
Hello everyone, I am Akshat Shishan, stand here to give my speech on topic failures are the pillars of success. Generally failures are bad, but sometimes failures may be constructive for someone. It can be stepping stone to the success. The pages of history shows that every successful man fails at a time. If we take lessons from it, failures may be constructive. The cause of failures may be lack of preparation, lack of concentration, lack of efforts, which shows us the cause of failures and take us to the point of failure. Failures and success are such as two faces of coins, which if we are sincere, active, then we are successful, and if we are careless and lazy, then we are failure. So we don't have to depressed and discouraged from failure, and we have to search the cause of failure and make correction in it and do the work with reformative way. Also, the success is not so easy. Success wants something from us. To get success, we have to concentrate and with positive thinking. Generally, race is not won by negative thinking. It is like failure, which leads us to success. So lastly, I want to say that failures are the path indicators which leads us to the success. Thank you.
Okay, very good. Start.
Good morning everyone, my name is Ashutosh Anand and I am going to deliver a short speech on the topic Necessity is a mother of invention. As you all know, the invention is not only the making of electrical appliances. As we face the situation and necessity, we go on doing invention. Like our forefather faces the situation, they roam here and there in search of food, and they leave their partners a miles back. So they have collected like they had collected a food or a flesh of animals. They have to sledge it to a miles. So they invented a wheel to make the work easier. So like this, as we are facing these situations, like anybody faces a situation, they have to travel in a water boat. So they had invented a ship which works electrically. And like we are facing the situation, we are enabled to travel with a bicycle, so we had invented a bike. Like this, our invention is a cycle which goes on doing always. So like this, I have my main intention to say that we should never stop doing the inventions. We should never stop doing the invention, because it is like we are facing the situations like we facing the situation like we are getting struck with a mosquito, so we had invented a mosquito net to prevent the bites of mosquito. So at last, I want to say that we should not stop doing the craft activities.
So why you have taken this topic?
Really, because like this, nowadays the children always playing game in our mobiles and resort, so we have to do the activity things.
Okay. Do you think that kind of quality you have?
Yeah.
Okay, any questions? From your side, any question? No question. You want to ask?
Good morning to all of you. I, Sachin, is from class 10, standing here to deliver insight on my topic, importance of friends. Friends are the most important in your life. They silently support our life. Certain feelings and emotions you not share with family, then share with friends. Friends are the most important of our childhood. Friends make our life beautiful. Friendship is not between two people. We become animal and friends both. Animals are also a help each other. At last, friendship is understanding, not awareness. It means for kindness, not for guilty.
Okay, very good. Start your topic.
Good morning to all of you. Today, I, Swati Kumari from class 10, will standing for to tell about a short speech. The topic of my speech is, I want to become a doctor in future. The aim of life is very important. It gives us a direction for our career. Everyone has an aim of life. An aim or ambition is what we want to be in future and choose a career after studies. The aim of my life is to become a doctor. The doctor is a saver of life, and they can help the people who need them when they feel sick. The service of a doctor is a valuable service, and they can help the people who need them. As I know that becoming a doctor is not a very easy task, but then I want to become a doctor. If I become a doctor, I will be very kind to the poor and the needy people. Helping the hopeless will be my main duty and practice. It is a long journey to study and then become a doctor, but I am having confidence in myself to finish my target and reach my goals. As I know that the income from here would be pretty less, but making money will not be my main aim.
Completed. Okay. Very good. At your topic, Prachi Priya.
I'm Prachi Priya, standing here to tell about my favorite leader. My favorite teacher is Narendra Damodar Das Modi, who was born in 17th September 1915. In Mehsana in Gujarat. His father Damodar Das Moolchand was trained in his big family by running a tea stall at Vudnagar railway station. His mother Heeraben is a simple housewife. Narendra Modi, only 8 years old, he helped his father at his tea stall. He worked at his elder brother in his tea stall at bus terminal also. So he was early childhood was somewhat is Hasid. Received his earlier education at Vudnagar. He played roles in theater also. He married at the age of 17, but he was not interested in his family life. So he left his house and joined RSS. In 1895 he joined BJP and he raised a strong voice against corruption. People of the nation gave him his full support. BJP comes out with absolute vote in Lok Sabha and became the 15th PM. Narendra Modi became the 15th Prime Minister of India. Thank you.
For your speech.
Good morning to all of you. I am today standing here to tell you about research topic, and my topic name is Safe Environment. Environment refers to natural surrounding and condition in which we live. Unfortunately, the environment has become under serious threat. This threat is almost entirely due to human activities. These human activities have certainly caused the damage to the environment. The damage risks the survival of living things on Earth. Therefore, there is an urgent need to save the environment. Planting trees should be given massive attention. A tree is the source of oxygen. Unfortunately, due to construction of many more trees have been cut down and reduce the amount of oxygen in the environment. Growing more trees means more oxygen, hence growing more trees would bring better life quality. People must give attention to forest conservation and forests are the vehicle for the environment. Deforestation certainly reduce the area of forest around the world. Soil conservation is the most important to save the environment. There must be control, landslide floods and soil erosion. Waste management is a way powerful of protecting the safe environment. There must be proper disposal of waste. This would help to keep the surrounding and healthy. Pollution is probably the biggest danger to the environment. Smoke, dust and chemical harmful gases cause air pollution. This cause air pollution become factories and vehicle mostly. Industries and pesticides are causing water and land.
A very good morning to one present here today. I, Sunil Kumari, standing before you to tell a very important topic, say water. As we know that the importance of water in our life, nowadays the lack of useful water in our surrounding area is the most serious topic. The water is a unique source for our life. Without water, we can't imagine life here. Life on the other planet is not possible just because absence of water. 3/4 of our surface is covered by water. However, lack of drinking water, only 1%. Water is an indispensable source for our earth, because it is regenerated and redistributed all over the earth through evaporation and rain. Since life on each and every living thing depends on water, water is a conservation technique to save clean and pure water for future use. Water is important for continuation of life on the earth. Water is a precious source for our life. Remember, what you waste in 2 minutes, what these people live for 2 days. At last, I say that water everywhere, but not off for drinking water. Save each and every drop of water. Save water, save life, save life.
Okay, very good, Simran. start your topic. What is your topic?
Good morning, everyone. Today I, Aspita, standing before you to deliver a speech on the topic human trafficking. Human trafficking is just another name for modern day slavery, wherein the victims involved are forced, conceived and deceived into labors and sexual exploitation. The figures are scary. Almost 6 to 8 lakh women and children are annually trafficked across national borders. Most human trafficking victims are actually duped into the trade by the false promises made regarding job opportunities. Many women from third world countries are lured into this trade with the bait of false marriages. Most of the victims are forced either with violence or indirectly with psychological blackmail into the trade. Once they enter the countries of trade, their passports are confiscated, and with no money, no shelter and no one to turn to, they are left at the mercy of those who trade in human flesh. Human trafficking is just a multifaceted threat. It drops people of their right of freedom. It is inhuman. The human in devastated, defeated and demoralized. Those who suffer physically and emotional abuse and rape may never be able to live normal life again. Those who are threatened lives in constant fear and end being psychologically compromised.
Very good. What is your topic?
Regulating the use of social media.
Okay, now start your topic.
Good morning all of you. I, Swati, standing before you to deliver the speech about regulating the use of social media. Today we live in the world of social media. Social media has been blamed for distributing disinformation and contributing to violence around the world. Any news, either it is good or bad, spread within a second. It is not denying the fact that it impacts our society. There is no denying that misinformation exists. Unscrupulous media publish deceitful report to endanger the harmony of our society. It influences the bottom part of our society that live in village areas. There are so many cases in which social harmony collapse only because of the false news spread by the social media platform. Today, hate speeches are made by some unidentified groups and published on different social media platforms, after which people believe on it blindly and make true or false perception about it. I am not going to tell that the effect of social media on society is always bad. It has good results also. So it is important to regulate a strict law to maintain such type of platforms, and so that social harmony maintained and people use it widely. Thank you.
Okay, Swati, why you have chosen this topic?
Social media is like part of our life today, and we should know the real use of social media. People misuse it
for
their own benefits, but we should know how to use it so that it can help us.
Okay, any question from your side?
Can you state some solution for the overuse of social media among the youth?
Overuse? It depends on you how you want to use it.
Okay. Okay, very good. Sit.